So guys, welcome to the first Blue Orchid Slam Fest. Glad to have everyone here. Sawyer boy.
I forget what I was going to say. I just passed everybody just now.
Tap.
Get the top.
Yes.
Get the
and that's Queen.
Popcorn seat. That's the people. As soon as you sit down, you lose. You pop right back up.
All right, guys. We're about to kick off. We're about to see who the best domino player is. But
I'm on video online with me playing domino.
You win, though.
Yeah.
See, because it's virtual, you know, you could always hack stuff and, you know.
You could hack, don't blame it on the Russians, not that quick.
Who's Russian?
Part Russian.
That's the problem.
I just rush with the Valley Boys.
Valley Boys, I can't even argue with the Valley Boys, even though it's not such thing as the Valley Boys anymore.
They still is a group?
Even though there's no such thing as Valley Boys. Okay.
They still is a group.
Oh, man.
Guys, let me ask you all a general question. Do you feel with people being at home, they're more engaged or less engaged with your content?
What?
I think people are more in line than ever, so.
Engage with what, each other, with social media?
No, in terms of your content, are people liking your content more, commenting more, sharing it more? Not really?
I think the only things that really picked up is live. When you go live, like you definitely see a jump in live feeds.
Right.
It's definitely a jump in live feeds. I think with me, I think my videos still run the same as they were.
It's good though, because even if you don't, we probably wouldn't realize it, there would be an increase on viewership because everybody home locked down and really nothing to do. So persons might be on social media looking for things to watch, looking for things to make them laugh. It was not versus like when persons were working late hours and persons were like out and about and stuff like that and had a lot of other things to do. So the fact that they're home now, there's a greater chance for them to see the content. The numbers haven't drastically changed to like significantly see that, unless you go to like DJ Overdose concert, and then when you see numbers like that, you're like, out of flip.
Yeah, and like I said, that's live feeds. The live feeds,
has there been a pressure to produce more content, or are you guys producing the same level of content?
I'm producing the same one. It's always a pressure, even before quarantine. You post a video today, tomorrow they waiting on the next video.
Wow. Boss.
I pass because I'm talking. I don't want to play right now. I just play on this time.
No, I'm gonna win this one.
Hey,
I know, but dad, you still get how much cards in your eye?
No, my Grammy always used to tell me, don't pick all that. Mine go off the tree before it ripe fully.
Why?
She used to tell me something like that.
That's a wise saying, that's good.
Yeah, she was a very wise woman.
Understood. So let me ask you guys, since all of you, you know, create content, how does it feel when you create something that you put a lot of time in and it falls flat?
Does it really fall flat though? Whether one person watch it or 100,000, does it really fall flat? I guess it depends on, I can't speak for them, I can speak for me. I think for me, it's just satisfying to get the content out rather than how much persons like or share it. I can't speak for them. What about you?
I could almost say the same. I just say whatever I put out is what I want to put out.
Right.
If you like it, you like it. If you don't like it, that's business. I still could put out something else.
It's my game.
No.
My game. Watch this. Bring it round time.
This boy get fucking, he get that too.
Yeah. Bring it round time. I got that too.
For real.
I got that too in my hand, and it's keeping me alive. Keeping me alive.
But you win though.
Information, young lady, we are broke, okay? You can't just red-handed.
The hustle is on as two young men try to go from broke to being bosses. Their desire for independence and wealth takes us on an adventure with their crazy, clever, and sometimes outrageous ideas.
Speaking of ideas, though. Yes, solid idea, but.
Here we go again.
So. Broke Bosses, Tuesdays at 8 p.m., channel 212, only on our TV.
Turn, go. Play something.
Let's go, then.
Quick. Oh, it's going. Okay, he played.
Hey, play that.
What we need to talk about is, you know what we need to talk about? We need to keep it real. Hold on.
You can throw it out there. Go ahead.
Yeah, I just have to, like, I tell you, like, can't walk and chew gum at the same time. I just have to play dental. But, like, I feel like being a creative in this country, it's just like, okay, like, how do y'all feel? Because I feel like all of us in here have been doing this for at least 5 years or more, for sure, right?
Yeah.
More than that. And have you seen, like, an outstanding or, like, an increase in the way Bahamians, as in the audience, right? But more so, like, the powers that be or the gatekeepers in... Oh, it's my turn. Okay. What was I saying? Like, has there been more, like, support? Like, I would personally say I feel like, especially with this quarantine, now people are starting to see how much more, like, online business and content creators are more important. You know what I mean?
Yeah, that too. But even before quarantine, we changed the game, especially us who inside you right now. Before quarantine, we changed a lot of things, but, like,
you think we changed enough, though?
No.
I remember it was like Stop Liking Man, that's when, and then Tap, Sawyer Boy, Marciano, those. What the other boy name? Guess Who Bought Again.
Yeah, that was Marciano and him, like, no generation.
Right. And then different King Cloud, all them started to come out. I think in that era, creators weren't getting as much support as we are now. You could tell and you could see a huge difference in the desire for creators, comedians, and personalities to now push businesses, to bring awareness to brands. They're now tapping into our numbers and into our following to get their businesses out, to get their product, their services out. So then, like, when, back in the day, they used to follow their phone, come to John's Lumber, 26 Wolf Road, and come and get your lumber today. Now, they want a funny video. They want something that relates to the crowd. Call Tap, call Toy Boy, call Dasco, call this person, that person, because we really want our business to get out there. So I think persons now see the value of, and me being in Collage Entertainment, I've seen the transition personally from what Tyrone, who's in charge of Collage Entertainment, was trying to accomplish with us, and how much of a hard time he was having versus how easy it is now.
I feel like I agree and I disagree. I don't think it's easier now. I feel, what the frick, who did that?
The same Russian.
Oh my God.
Whoa!
My God, really?
I think that's a slide effect.
Wait, why is Fabian even playing?
You shouldn't be playing.
You're
not gonna make no videos.
Yeah, I thought this was just like us.
Make videos, but I don't see him in it.
I don't see him, like,
I don't know what he is. He's playing with his friends with your granddaddy.
Stop playing.
I just oil in the wheel. What happened? When the conversation goes.
Oh, Fabian, you were playing with your granddaddy them. They used to be in the backyard drinking.
If you want to play, play bad. Play bad. I feel like I agree and I disagree. Like, honestly, I'll keep it real. Like, me and Sawyer have these conversations all the time, or, like, quite frequently. I think a major problem in our industry is too much of us, like, do a crappy job of having standards for themselves and explaining to these people amount of value that goes into our work. I feel like the market right now is trash, if I can keep it real. Just for me, I also work, like, in a behind the scenes capacity, like, with marketing and stuff like that. Mm-hmm. And I see what's being offered and what's being accepted, and I think it's garbage. Right. And I feel like we need to raise our standards and explain to these people why certain things are the way they are. You know, how much hours goes into the editing, how much hours
goes into whatever. Talk and play.
Okay. Hell, fuck, did it play?
She was gone just now.
Eat me out. Eat me.
I was also leaning on the point that I think, you know, internationally, the government or like organizations would spend so much money in pushing like athletics and and other platforms. But when it comes to like entertainers, comedians, content creators, they don't really push. They don't look for big opportunities to send us to. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
Like they do with platforms.
And it's sad because it's like, I'm sorry, we have the most talent. Like we're naturally, and in none of us who are in this room and also the other ones that we know, none of us went to school for this.
No.
Like we naturally doing these things. We had to teach ourselves how to edit, how to film, how to do all these things. And it's like, imagine if we actually had the support where like, you know, they do things, represent the country, whatever that looks like. Like we could be so much further.
And then it's sad that the only Bahamians that get recognition or get hype or get honored are the ones that actually go themselves and make it international. Then Bahamians like,
well, I'm going to say something that may be kind of controversial to some people, but for instance, that dude the other day, who was like the first black valedictorian. And everyone's like, Bahamas flag emoji in the comments. And I'm like, listen here. I find it so interesting that this boy didn't even, let me make this very clear. I'm not trying to take away from his Bahamianness because it's like, I'm half Jamaican and I recognize that culture, even though I didn't grow up in that culture. So I would hope if I did something for Jamaica, they'll be happy or whatever. I'm not saying just because you didn't grow up here, you can't connect the culture or recognize it. But I find it very interesting that you have people who are born in this country, right? First of all, Bahamians won't even claim them. And I know it's very...
You're talking about the person who changed their nationality?
Ooh.
You don't know?
Who changed their nationality?
I'm blocking up this game.
I don't talk about it. But I'm saying, it's so interesting how everyone's quick to claim him. And it's like, he didn't grow up here. But people who are here, they don't really claim. And I feel like... we need to look at why we as people seek outside validation so much. Why is it when an outside source says, oh my God, this person is worthy, this person is valuable, then everyone hops on the bandwagon. I'm not saying people shouldn't praise that guy and say like, oh my God, his parents are Bahamian. But it's like, first of all, you have people here who are doing major things, right? And then you have people, I find it kind of hypocritical, like there's people, and I know this is a polarizing issue as well. You have kids here who are born here, grew up here, their parents are Haitian, Bahamians ain't claiming them.
No.
That's a fact. First of all, some of these people ain't even straight legally, even though they born here, live up here, talk like us, but y'all won't claim them and y'all will fight for them to say, well, their parents are Haitian, they're whatever. But it's like someone else who wasn't born here, but yes, they have Bahamian roots, y'all can claim them. I find it kind of hypocritical, but that's just me.
And you can imagine how much others, not straying from us as creators, but you can imagine how much others that we probably didn't even think about, other like demographics or groups or whatever, who feel, Bahamian groups that feel like they don't have the support and they have resources, they could bring income. And even on your point of validation, we need tourism to survive. So we need the validation of their money and their visit to feel like, you know, this is paradise. Now, look at the economy now, what we can
look do. Look at it now. I was going to ask you, do we need tourism? This needs to show us that
we need to be diversifying.
We need to be
putting so much money in carnival to go on the road and shake up. Put a million on this island and do all the pineapple. Put it on this and open up a craft factory. Put it on this and, you know, capitalize on our own crop, our own stock on a large scale. So we don't have to import so much.
And on food, exactly.
No.
Now we're suffering for it now because we didn't do that. It's messed up.
How long it could take for tourists to come back here comfortably? Well, I think people still traveling right now, so.
Yeah, but it ain't gonna be that big boom right away like how it was, you know what I mean? Like, it's crazy.
How do you change, I've been thinking about that for years, how do you change like getting the support? And that's why I think we get so comfortable in, you know what, if persons like it, they like it, if they don't, they don't. I'm going to fend for myself and create my own platform because no one out there is really trying to help create it for us.
Right. And I feel like for all of us, it comes natural. It's like, again, this is a passion. If it wasn't a passion, we wouldn't last as long. Because ain't none of us are millionaires yet, okay? But it's a passion. It's like breathing. You can't help but to create. You know what I mean?
It's so, my game again. Just saying.
That's what it is. Oh, why are you even playing? Why?
You can't play no more.
Bitch, did you only play?
Sweet heart, you just need to take me over. You get a sweet heart, easy. Now you can't ask me no more.
Why you talking to that little boy like that? Just come let this little boy fool you. I know.
Why you gotta talk to that little boy like that?
Miss Zoe, that's your mommy.
The fact is what you want. Yes, that's my mommy.
And two.
Every time I gotta go to the store,
hey, that's how they go vehemence, boy.
No man gives to anyone unless it's pocket.
I don't play basketball.
I don't play pocket. You don't wanna be
late. Watch this, y'all.
Fine. That's what he set up the game for. He set up the game to take a pass.
And yeah, now everyone gonna take my hype away, Dred.
Everyone take a pass now.
Watch this, y'all.
Fine. Everyone.
Well, hype me up and then take my hype away.
Set that up for us, eh? Don't scare, put that to like, you got a piece of five.
Watch this. I know why I'm hyping myself up, but watch this. Peace?
Peace? Woo! Oh, you mean. You mean.
Wait, so you stop playing, boy? Why every time I do something, you go,
Cassie.
Every time I make a move.
Watch how much points I get right now when I win.
After this game, we can't change seating. You know, it's the popcorn seat.
I get 200 points right now.
Tap in the popcorn seat.
I get 200 points right now. What's this? 200
popcorn seat is?
200 points.
But I feel like it's bad.
Yeah.
I feel like it's bad. Whatever it is, that's what I mean. It's bad juju.
Yeah, that's popcorn seat. That's the people. As soon as you sit down, you lose. You pop right back up. The popcorn seat. Whoa.
Hey, come through. Vocals.
Let me ask you guys, as creatives, and similar to us, you know, as a creative agency, we find challenges also where you have a person's pushing down the price of your work. Does that happen often with you guys in terms of competing against other influencers who may come in at a cheaper price?
First of all,
Say it again.
He asking if people be trying to push down the price of what we trying to do.
Yes.
Especially that all the time. All the damn time.
The reality is there are a lot of gigs that persons are getting because they are cheaper price.
It's damn cheap. Charging $50 a thing.
There are gigs that persons are getting at a cheaper rate because these people are strong arming and they know how to fix their words. Like, okay, we just want one small little video. You ain't that much. You don't gotta do much. You just a little small thing to promote our waist trainers, you know, and we just want you to do a little something. You know what I used to do your thing. When you create that, now you get your camera, you use your gas, you get your light.
And the editing. That's the work.
Manpower to come and shoot. You got somebody holding stuff on the side. Mm-hmm. And then you create this video, you go home, you edit, you send it. They have 15 changes to it. You have to create a graphic to put at the end. You have to put a voiceover at the end. Shop to racetrainers242.com. Shop to racetrainers242.com.
Is that a paid ad?
It's supposed to be a separate course. And then when you send that, they're like, okay, we love it, but can you just switch this number? We changed our WhatsApp yesterday. Yeah. So now you got to go back, change it again, send it to them. And then they take their long to put it out. And then they say, oh, this is our budget. And then next thing you look, hey, you get a call. Hey, I just see a commercial the race train is on television. And you're like, what? They got television money?
Exactly. No, but people need to know how to say no. I think a lot of our people don't know how to say no. And I think it's important for us as creatives to have, I mean, because it ain't that many of us, you know what I mean? I think it's important for us to have relationships where we can talk to one another. I know a lot of times people ask me to do things and then I find it okay. They're asking Sawyer or they're asking Zaneo or Wendy or whoever, because I know these people. I hit them up and we talk behind the scenes and we say like, okay, like we don't need to settle. So I feel like it's okay to say no, and that ain't just for creatives. That's for everyone in life. Like, you don't have to say yes to everything. And you know what I hate when they do? When they be like, oh, we're doing this, and that's Quay said he's going to do it for $100. Like, why are you telling me other people's business? I hate that.
Sometimes sometimes it is be false.
Sometimes it is be false. I know that, because I hit people up, and I'd be like, are you doing such and such? And they're like, no.
Give me the skin. I block it up.
I block it up.
Why do you keep on wearing these?
I was so close. Look at how close I was.
I blocked it up just now.
This fight, just ain't talking and he just winning again. Like, I don't really appreciate that. Why, dog? Just cheating, but you getting in our head, buddy.
Where'd Taylor Rose go?
What's that doing?
Nine even it.
My thing is, boy, if people want you, they could pay the money for you. If they really want you. And it's just a matter of really putting yourself out there. And like I say, but right now, if people want you, great, to host this
event. You know why I don't like that too, Sawyer? You know why I don't like that too?
What's that?
If my cousin reach out to me and I say, I'll do it for you for your budget because, you know.
Because we family.
Then you go to someone else and say,
tell them,
$150.
I tell people,
I work in a day for you because we cool. I work in a day for you. So why are you making it look now?
Look like,
this other person's like, I'm charging this low.
No, they wrong for that.
I tell people, look here, this is your price. That's how I tell people, look here, this is your price because you just starting your business and I work with you because you like me. Like this completely different from
a big company.
A big company. Mm-hmm. And I tell the big company, like, buy this your price. You can do it. If you get this amount of money you want paid, then I give you what I will. If you say you get $500, or maybe you only get $500, I'm giving you $500.
Value, exactly.
I ain't giving you $1,500 worth of nothing.
Right.
No, I good. My kids love noodles. Like, I good, though.
Yo, don't sleep on noodles.
Oh, noodles is the best. I have to eat spaghetti for days.
You talking about price here? Like my kids could
have spaghetti.
Got it mad because he no noodles near right now.
Daddy noodles? Noodles, daddy?
But not that one. The big one. The big one. Oreo and stuff.
Love Oreos.
Taylor was one Oreo. And she got in the fridge and eating sausage cold.
Wow.
When you call him, what you doing? I swear she do that. I call her and she stuff everything inside her mouth. That's like, who teach you that? Like, you three.
Well, you do the Tingham challenge with her. I didn't see the fruit snacks challenge.
What was that?
The fruit snacks challenge. You did that with her. I didn't see.
Well, I never see a fruit snack challenge
before. What? That's what it is. Like, put the, it could be any snack. It could be fruit snacks cookies.
Oh.
And you put a snack in front of them and you'd be like, okay, don't touch this. And you record to see if they move it or not. If they
listen. I ain't.
Put her favorite snack in front of her in a bowl and say, I leave and don't touch it. And then put the camera on and see if she actually tries to.
I saw them. I didn't know what it was. Everything's a challenge now.
Yeah. People bored.
So what the story is, might be anyone else winning games except for your favorite?
Yeah. So Sawyer Boy got two, Daspy got one, and Top got
Games, bro.
App has a lot of faith, I believe.
No, how did I get one? I win like two games.
Yeah, you win two games in a different series. You started a new series a long time ago.
So what it is now? Three. You have three.
I have three. That's where I have one, and Sawyer Boy got two. You're in Top have one of those numbers that don't have no numbers.
Serious, a computer.
Maybe, and it's problematic.
Three is a computer.
Alright, let's finish it.
Make me happy. Yeah. This you can bear. You still right beside me. Yeah. And I won't forget. Give me the skin. Yeah. Model set.
Finally win one. I just gotta win this game just now too.
Welcome, Top.
I had the 5-2, right?
You're
welcome. Good dog.
I know he's used to win, so I say, let me just, because he's losing.
I won.
You know I'm mad because you have more points than me, right?
Look at that.
All right, y'all play Chrissy.
Wait. Oh,
so guys, if you had any closing thoughts for up and coming creatives, what would that be in terms of support?
Move to America.
Canada.
Oh yeah, Canada. They're more like open, eh? Yeah. That's it.
And it's sad that is the our thought. Like, we don't be excited to stay in, but we gotta do. We gotta be like, all right, we gotta go to States or go to Canada to really get.
Pop off.
Yeah, the pop off. Pop off.
Notice y'all are haters. Yeah, nobody said congratulations for my win. Not even Fabian. He was so proud to say I had 0. Now I have 41 points. I have more than Dasquay.
I see you.
Haters.
I see you. You on the board and you bossing right now.
Yes.
Yeah, you really come from behind. You know that.
Okay, you're close to the bottom door, please. Be quiet. Who blinked? You catching the biggie bag ride on your sister back? Call them for what? No.
Because when I think of you, I shine.
I don't know the words
either, but I'm about to jam it while we play. Hold on.
Here, you can see
what's that name? What's that name?
That name.
You curry?
Before I let go?
Yeah.
I gotta make a run before Faith is starting on.
Faith is starting in 20 minutes.
We can wrap up in 10 minutes, eh?
Thank you. All right. Some Oreos. Hey,
we can win all these games right now, though. Let's go. Let me show you something real quick.
I win?
That's how it look.
Hey, where'd he go? He's gonna miss
his I don't turn. Know, that's quick.
Wait, you're gonna miss your turn. You're gonna miss your turn. Oh.
Peace. You poke somebody in the back.
I appreciate you. I needed to get my double three.
Why are you even playing right now?
You gotta run this again without you. We'll never know. Yeah. And we'll record another conversation. We can put it up.
She wants to be here with us. That's she wants to play with you. Don't walk. No, but she don't have to walk. If she have you, carry. Keep on carrying on your back. Don't come off, Taylor Rose. Hold on tight. Hold on tight, Taylor Rose.
Don't bite me.
Hey, no biting me.
Bad move.
No biting. Oh, okay. Here, follow me, go for me. What you doing?
That's foolishness.
I was close.
That's me, y'all. That's my game.
No cigar.
That's foolishness.
That's my game. I got 2 points. That's me, right?
All I know is I have more points than that queen.
That's all this one.
Okay, guys. This is the last game. This is for all the marbles, eh?
Start it up, you go.
All the marbles.
Let's go, Sawyer boy. I need you to drop the domino.
Come on, watch the white. Watch this.
That's way.
No, but I win though.
I was jamming, sorry.
Right. Yeah, I think double six pulls.
Huh?
I know what happened there.
I win that because I had double one.
Yeah, I know how that's where you get the pulls.
Yeah, you had the least amount, the lowest
card. I have the least amount of points. So
the lowest card.
You know, they say first the way, second the best, third the good. What? Why you on the camera by side? What happened to you, bro?
That's the whore.
I'm top with all the lip gloss.
This boy have a lot of issues.
You know, used to make me mad when we leave in church. My mommy used to put on makeup to go home.
Why?
She said what?
She used to like, she used to refresh her makeup from the church to go home. And I'm like,
never know what happened on your way home.
Yeah, I was gonna say, maybe she would clean like y'all break down or something. She sees.
Yeah,
something.
And like one big strapping man just come out. You need a lip.
Never know. My lips are just dry. That's all.
Not really. All right, this is a championship game. Winner takes all.
Watch this, y'all. Watch this. Michelle, y'all. Watch his wife.
You watch him.
Watch.
You watch him.
Boom, right? That's the setup for what's happening and happen later.
So what I could do, I could drop this 0-4, right? Because there's 3-4s on the field. Watch this. It's a science to this.
I know what you're trying to do.
No. Actually, you know what?
1-2.
All right, so that's 4-5. Now watch this. If I play double 5 here, a 4 to feel, he can feel emotionally unavailable because nobody on his run, right? See? Now he depressed. But the 6, because he's a 6, he feels more competent, more ready. You know what I mean? So it's an emotional game.
Keep talking. You don't get to play. Just go ahead. Keep talking.
All right. So, see, it's an emotional game. You know what I mean?
I hear you. Keep talking again.
Watch this. Watch this. What I have in my hand, I can bust a 3-card flush on all you, right?
Yeah. No, keep on talking.
So I pass now. But that's just setting me up for my victory later. Come on, somebody.
Right.
Sometimes in the season, it ain't all about winning. It's about the setup.
Yes.
So set it up. Watch this. I can play this.
Right.
Yes. And I'll be like, oh my God, he played number one.
Wow.
And then this boy can play and win.
I can spray everybody with red, right?
I can run hot. Because it's emotional, like I was saying.
Okay, it shouldn't even be played.
So guys, I definitely want to say I appreciate everyone taking the time out to join us. It was definitely fun. And we definitely learned a lot, you know, about how creativity works, how you guys think, and definitely some of the challenges you guys have in the market now. But definitely, you know, I want to say I appreciate you all, and I think overall, in terms of the environment, everyone enjoys your content, and we couldn't do it without you guys. So definitely, you know, keep striving, keep doing it, and keep being creative. But thank you all.
Thank you for that encouragement. Y'all come next week, come see me and Samuno.
Understood.
Come see me.
No, do y'all play Taboo? I'm really good at that game.
Come see me in Uno. I bet you don't even drop no Duke on me.